In this brief video, I'm going to show you the basic setup of an operating microscope for cataract surgery. The tilting adjustment knob sets the optical axis of the microscope. Usually, a no-tilt setting is recommended. In this way, the optic is perpendicular to the floor. In selected cases, it is possible to tilt the microscope up to 20 degrees posteriorly to reduce the flexion of the elbows. A side indicator shows how far the axis deviates from the perpendicularity. Each eyepiece has a diopter regulation ring to set the personal spherical refractive defect. If you use your glasses or contact lenses, it is better to set on zero, although young surgeons with a large accommodative reserve sometimes find more comfortable a slightly negative setting. You can adjust the interpupillary distance using the specific setting wheel. On Eiger values, it is impossible to get the image's fusion. Instead, on lower values, you could have stereopsis anyway, but only engaging your own convergence capability, with consequent early visual exhaustion. Therefore, during the EPD setting, it is better to start from a wider interpupillary distance and gradually lower it until getting the image's fusion over the whole field. The eyepiece's alignment should be parallel to the floor or slightly downward. These positions allow to keep the head straight, reducing the load on cervical spine. It is not recommended to point eyepieces upwards, cause it increases cervical lordosis and leads to excessive eyelid opening, with increased interblink interval and visual aberrations. Rotation of the sterile handles releases the electromagnetic brakes of the main arm, and it is possible to move the microscope along the three axes of the space. If the microscope does not perfectly remain in the desired position, you have to calibrate the balance using the knob at the base of the main arm. After every surgery, you have to press the reset button of the XY joint, which resets the position of the joint and also the zoom, focus, and lights. The microscope has two types of illumination, coaxial light and oblique light. The coaxial light follows the eyepiece's axis almost perfectly. It just lights up the center of the field for 20 mm in diameter. It helps to get the red reflex in backlighting, a crucial feature during the capsulorhexis, the cortical masses removal, and the IOL positioning. Oblique light is instead misaligned with the optics. It is widespread and illuminates the whole field surface. Regardless of the model, the microscope pedal always has a central rest bar, two pairs of heel and metatarsal buttons to adjust focus and magnification, and a XY toes joystick. On the edges, there is a set of programmable buttons to activate and deactivate each type of light and, on demand, balance them in order to obtain the desired proportion. These are the main settings of a surgical ophthalmic microscope. Thank you for your attention.